श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
I invite you to this Unchavritti video and later a bit of Tyagaraja Ghanaraga Pancharatna Goshti Gayana featuring the five most venerated songs by this saint amongst a musician and a musician amongst the saints of the country, Bharata. I endeavor to give you a life sketch of Tyagaraja all along this video feature so that one would understand in awe the greatness of a Bharatiya Sangeetagara, the musician, his life, achievements, and the awe-inspiring cultural soul of Bharata that gave birth to such an everlasting personality to influence and guide the music called Karnataka Sangeeta to this day. Santa Shri Tyagaraja lived between 1767 and 1847. He is the most popular, most prolific and versatile composer of the Kriti form of Karnataka music. He is venerated as a Santa Sangeetagara by millions, not merely because he attained self-realization through music, but also because he taught in his songs the enduring values of love of God and of fellow beings, introspection, social consciousness, responsibilities, duties, and so forth. All this great work are esteemed in Bharata, in Karnataka Sangeeta, as Tyaga Brahmopanishad. He is rightly regarded as the musical Valmiki. He is also the largest single force who shaped South Indian music. He is also perhaps the only music composer and teacher who had the largest number of disciples who carried on the mission and message through their own schools. Amongst some 700 kritis of the saint, a group of five songs composed in five classical Ghana ragas are the foremost and are universally esteemed as the five gems, the Pancharatna. They are amongst the most widely sung, as witnessed, for instance, in the annual Tyagaraja Aradhana every part of our world with Karnataka musicians and at the saint's own samadhi in Tiruvayyaru. He was born as the third and the youngest son in a family of Telugu Mulukanadu Brahmanas belonging to the Kakarla genealogy, Apastamba Sutra and Bharadwaja Gotra, to the blessed couple Rama Brahma and Sitamma at Tiruvarur near Tanjavur. This worthy son was named as Tyagaraja in obeisance to the principal deity of Tiruvarur. The family was adorned with musicians of high order on both sides of Tyagaraja's parents. Legend has it that his mother Sitamma had a large musical repertoire of songs of Andhra music composers and of the Haridasa composers of Karnataka, especially Sri Purandaradasa. Thus, Tyagaraja inherited both aptitude for music and devotion to Shri Rama. Rama Brahma decided to leave Tiruvaruru when Tyagaraja was a young boy. Father encouraged Tyagaraja in his musical talent by arranging musical lessons from a very well-known musicians of the royal court, Sonti Venkata Ramanaya. Tyagaraja soon mastered the theory and practice of music. His father performed Tyagaraja's Upanayana. He married Shanta. His mother died when he was just 15 and his father a few years later. In the meanwhile, his natural instinct for composing songs culminated into versatile, fluent and influential music composer of all times and into an architect of modern Karnataka music. After marriage, Tyagaraja adapted his life as a householder to that of a Bhagavata Dharma and took up Unchavritti, which means living a life of total surrender to God, living on alms voluntarily given by people when the Bhagavata walks the streets performing Haribhajana. Thus, he opted a life of poverty and love of God, eschewing all temptation of worldly fame and riches with the full cooperation and participation of his wife. His fame thus spread far and wide, attracting disciples and devotees. Many famous religious leaders and musical leaders visited him and paid their respects. He undertook pilgrimage to holy shrines in Tamil Nadu and composed many sets of songs out of divine fervor. The Upanishad Brahma saint initiated Tyagaraja into the Rama Taraka mantra and prescribed it to be repeated 96 crores of times. Tyagaraja is said to have done so and had the vision of his Ishta Daivata. He had a peaceful, long, rich life of God intoxication and of fulfilling of his ideals. It is believed that emancipation was promised to him only in the next, and he circumvented another birth by taking on the next ashrama, that is the Sannyas ashrama, in which he assumed the ashrama nama Nada Brahmananda in the last days of his life. He predicted the date and time of shuffling of his mortal coil and did so indeed amidst his numerous disciples on the early morning of 6th of January 1847. This story and the great man is indeed awe-inspiring for all of us. But what is there for us to follow? Why should we do the Unchavritti now? The Goshti Gana? The answer is simple and worthy of meditating upon. We need to be at peace with ourselves. We need cultural identity to do this, and Tyagaraja's life and final emancipation will inspire us into a path to realize this goal in our lives and perhaps in the lives of our dear ones and children.
Shri Rama Jaya Rama Jaya Jaya Rama Shri